Once again, here's our single-ended design with the long line. And now I'm going to use an iProbe instead of collecting data at the VOUT node. In the simulation palette for transient, we have two iProbe components, the single-ended and then the differential. So I'm going to insert the single-ended right here. That's the same point at which I have my node name. Now, if we edit this iProbe component, you'll notice that it has two tabs, parameters, and measurements. And at the bottom of the parameters tab is this disable transient analysis output. And by checking this box, it means that we won't collect all the data. So if you have a long simulation time and you don't want all the data, that's the convenience of using an iProbe. And in the measurements tab, you can see what we'll get. This is a density plot, and there are other measurements available, including waveform. By default, we get density. So I'm going to click OK and run the simulation. Now, because we're not going to collect any data, we won't have any at this node. And you could easily remove the node. So it's a convenience to get eye diagrams, or in our case, density plots. We simply use eye probes wherever we want. Let's go ahead now and run the simulation and look at the results. Here in the status window, you can see that one of the information messages is that the iProbe is suppressing the transient data, so we don't have to collect all the data. That's one of the nice things about using the iProbe. Now let's go to the data display. I've inserted a rectangular plot. Here's our data set. Notice that it doesn't have all of the usual transient data. For example, we don't have our VOUT node data, so we don't have the time steps. We don't have all of that. But we do have our density measurement, and we simply add that and click OK. And here's the density plot with our nice eye opening because I kept it with that tune value for the impedance. So what we have here is really a quantization of the X and Y axes. And it's really for visual purposes. It's an average of everything. And so we don't have to show all the lines, that is, all those pieces of data, those time points from transient. You can also use the tuner, and you would see the eye close or open accordingly to what you were tuning. And now let's get to our last two examples for transient convolution, the differential line and a four-port S-parameter measurement-based file. Here's our differential line example. I simply inserted a differential line from the transmission line palette, used the same substrate, all the same basic variables. Now we have two pseudorandom bit sequence sources, and to get this differential signal, you set it like this. VLOW is 0, and down here in the other one, VLOW is 1. Conversely, VHIGH is 1 here, and VHIGH is 0 here. That's how you get your differential signal. Everything else is basically the same. I have two nodes, V positive and V negative, so VP and VN, and that's where I'll get my data. Let's run the simulation and let me show you the results. And here they are. I inserted an equation because I need to pass the difference between the positive and the negative into my front panel function here. So V out equals VP minus VN, and you can see that here. Simply pass it in here by typing it in, and there's our nice eye diagram. And I use that same 64 ohms for the simulation, and so I would expect that I would get a pretty good eye. And here you see the density plot using an eye probe. So if we look back in schematic, I simply inserted the differential eye probe here and connected it, and then I checked off that setting not to save the transient data, so these two are ignored. I don't collect the data. And I simply inserted another rectangular plot, selected a different data set, and then I selected density as I did before, and you can see the results here. Just the basic eye opening that we have, only this one uses the iProbe density plot. Now, let's move on and look at our file-based design. And here is our last example for transient convolution using an SNP component because it's file-based measured data. From the data items palette, you simply select the one depending upon the number of ports. In this case, it's 4 ports, and then you can browse to the location of the file, and then the file name appears. That's how easy it is to set it up. If you use the edit button, you'll be able to look at the measured data, all the frequency points, the magnitude and angle in this case, and now we can run the simulation. I've set Z0 to 50 ohms, a good value considering it's measured data, and it has the same differential signal that we saw before. And you could use an eye probe here if you wanted to, but I've chosen to use simply the same convention of collecting the data at the positive and negative ports. Let me show you the results. And here they are. I've written an equation V out, which is equal to, again, positive minus negative, and then I simply pass that in right here when I type in that front panel function for the rectangular plot. And what we have is a very realistic eye diagram for a very realistic four-port measured data file-based setup with differential signal and transient convolution simulation. And now we'll spend the last few moments of our video looking at the Ats Channel Simulator. I'll show you an example and how to use it, and specifically what sources must be used for channel simulation. To demonstrate the channel simulator, I'm going to use some built-in projects. So if you go to the View Example directory and then look in the Signal Integrity folder, there it is, you'll see several projects. I'm going to use this channel simulator here, the Interconnect project. There's also a tutorial, and either one of those are fine to learn it and set up for your own design. Let's go ahead and look at the first one. Here's the first design with its detail. Basically, we have two package models on the input and output. And pushing in, you can see this is a ball grid array, and it's basically a file. It's an S8P component. So we have two of those, one on either side. And then we have the via breakout. So here's another file for that cabling. And then we have this coupled line here, which has varying widths and lengths, and you can see the substrate definition, including the spacings, and then our interconnect between the two, and again, another file. So it's a complex circuit in that it's hierarchical, and there are a lot of parameters. And now let's see how this example simulation is set up using the components from the channel simulation palette, and you should always use only these components. Here's the controller. There's transmitters and receivers, and let me show you the detail about how this is set up. It has a channel simulator. Normally you only set up the number of bits you want to run. It has a transmitter here, which is the only source you want to use for the channel simulation. It has the pseudorandom bit sequence set up here, so you can have the bit rate. You can set the voltages here, the rise and fall. It has an encoder. In this case, it is using the 8B10B. It has an equalizer, so you can set up taps, and you can add jitter. And this is also true of the receiver, and that's here. You can add jitter, and it has the equalizer here for a tap. Let's go ahead and run the simulation, keeping in mind it has the same eye probes that we've already seen, and the measurements will be available. These are all the default measurements. Strictly density is the main thing we're interested in. Let's cancel this and run the simulation. And the status window will show you everything that's going on. Down here you'll see a small message. It'll look like transient's running first because it does use the impulse response, but then it does its own calculations after that. This solved in about 77 seconds. Let's look at the results. And here they are. You can see both the differential and the single-ended eye diagrams hit the same thing fundamentally, and then the measurements here that are also part of the eye probe. Now, if we were to compare this to running a transient simulation, let me show you what you would get.